conflicting things. Right. The Associated Press and Reuters are reporting that the Venezuelan Defense Minister Vladimir Padrino has just said, quote, acts of violence by some members of the armed forces today have been, quote unquote, partly defeated, and that the military's top ranks remain, quote, loyal to the Constitution, which I would imagine means loyal to Maduro. At least that's what they want. But Congressman Waltz, this is also happening. We've been watching the Venezuelan opposition leader Guaido and right. his mentor and ally, Leopold Lopez, who escaped house arrest earlier today, marching among the protesters, claiming that they have victory in this and the military is with them. Your former military, where are the facts in all of this?
So, Harris, I just met this morning with Admiral Fowler, the commander of our Southern Command based out of Miami. He's testifying before the Armed Services Committee tomorrow. So a few things here to add to your points. One is that the Venezuelan Army Chief has moved over with Guaido. That's what we understand we're hearing here. And the release of Lopez was not an accident. He was under house arrest held by the military. And he was released as well by factions of the military. So we're starting to see that breakaway and that inflection point, and they now control an airbase. Here's where I am. I think it is time for the United States to continue to lead a humanitarian effort. There's 3 million Venezuelans and counting that have fled into Colombia, Brazil, or destabilizing the region, but we have to do it as a coalition. I think if we do it by ourselves, it could give Maduro an excuse for a backlash. The Brazilians are ready to go. The Colombians are ready to go. We should ask the French and the Dutch, who have former protectorates down in the Caribbean, to also participate. If Guaido is seen as leading a coalition-led humanitarian effort and delivering for the needs of the people when Maduro has not, I think that could be the final breaking point. That could do it. Also, I think Guaido would be, it would be helpful if they would offer an amnesty deal to the remaining members of the Venezuelan military to bring them over as well. But the bottom line is, and a lot of people are asking, this isn't hundreds of thousands of U.S. boots on the ground. This is a coalition effort, planes and ships that will move that peace in. If we don't do it, the Chinese and Russians will, and the Cubans are already there in the thousands protecting Maduro.
All right. How much damage does it do for Maduro for you to see those? And I put this in these terms because what you're talking about is trying to get a coalition against a coalition, because remember, his has Russia in it. We'll get to that in a moment. But what does it do for all of this to see a military tank roll over people?
Well, I think it just shows the true colors of the Maduro regime. They're only concerned at the end of the day with their own survival. Keep in mind, his entire inner circle, those protecting him, those are all Cuban Castro regime security officials. The Cubans are the one propping up Maduro, and without them, he would not be in power. They're also the ones persecuting any military members who side with, what's an important point, which is Guaido's constitutionally backed ascension to power. This is not a coup. But at the end of the day, the Lima Group is leading with U.S. leadership, and the Trump administration deserves credit for this, an entire, a large group of South American and international allies that are on the side of freedom.
It's interesting because historically it was very rare for President Trump to recognize an opposition leader in Juan Guaido as the legitimate leader. So you talk about a difference, a game change, if you will, that plays a role in that heavily. I know you've been closely working with Florida Senators Marco Rubio and Rick Scott, and you've been very vocal about the Maduro regime and the crisis in Venezuela. Three of you now have just introduced a bill. Quickly tell me about what you're trying to do.
So we've introduced a bill that basically says if you're doing business with the Maduro regime, you can't do a business with America. My colleague Mario Diaz-Balart from Miami has also been leading. This is bipartisan. Donna Shalala and others, this is Democrats and Republicans in Florida who see this as a future. But Harris, I think this is a more broadly a big opportunity for the United States to reassert itself in Latin America, where the Chinese are all over the place. Half the countries in Latin America have signed up to One Belt, One Road, which is, you know, basically Chinese payday lending and takeover scheme through soft power of Latin America. They've seen now what socialism will do They are moving towards the United States, but we have to seize the moment. The moment is now.
You know, I want to further it, though. I want to bring in communism, too, because the socialism is the economic dissolve, the disruption, the tragedy that has happened in Venezuela. But the communist part of this is important, too.
Yeah, well, look, so it's always worth remembering Venezuela was the wealthiest country in South America, still sitting on the world's largest known oil reserves, and the place is a disaster with 3 million people fleeing. It's destabilizing Colombia, it's starting to destabilize Brazil. We have to, again, this is the moment, their lives are on the line, portions of the military have broken away, and I think we need to step in with a coalition and support this effort and push it over the finish line. Otherwise, the Cubans are going to solidify their hold. Mm-hmm. And keep in mind, if Maduro goes, I think the Cuban regime is not long to follow, because they shifted their dependence from the Soviet Union to Venezuela years ago. So this could have massive effects for the region.
Well, it is fascinating to watch this unfold, and the violence has just been soul-jarring today to see some of the things that have played out on the streets with military vehicles against people. Yeah. I get it, and you talked a little bit about the game change that this has been with the Trump administration. We'll stay on the story today. I almost called you Colonel Waltz, because I have for so long. Congressman Waltz, thank you very much for being with me on the Breaking News.
Yes, ma'am, Harry.